What is the difference between a DVR and NVR for security camera recording? Hey everyone, Mike from CCTV Camera Pros here. And in this video, I'm going to talk you through some of the difference between a security camera DVR and NVR. And I'm in some cases talking specifically about our Viewtron DVRs and NVRs that we supply. So let's talk about some basics here. DVR stands for digital video recorder and almost always refers to CCTV cameras, otherwise known as BNC cameras that run over coax cable, a BNC connector plugs into the camera, and a coax cable runs back to the DVR, BNC connector into the back of the DVR, and then there's a separate power supply, sometimes a power supply box, but that power supply is supplied externally from the DVR. A NVR stands for network video recorder and is used for IP cameras. Use network cable, Cat5e or Cat6 cable, and on the back of our Viewtron NVR, there's power over Ethernet port, so you can plug that network cable from the camera into the back of the NVR, and that one cable is providing both the connectivity as well as the power between the NVR and the IP camera. If you are installing a new system and you don't have any cable in place, it's a no-brainer to go with IP cameras. They're the newer technology, there's a number of advantages to them, and there's not a lot to consider in the way of going with a coax DVR system. Now, where some questions and trade-offs come into place is if you're replacing an old DVR and upgrading your system and you have coax cable in place. And let me just mention, our Viewtron DVRs are hybrid. They work with all of the old CCTV cameras as well as the latest 2 megapixel, 4 megapixel, and 4K BNC cameras. So you can go HD over coax. And our Viewtron hybrid DVRs also support IP cameras. So why would you go with an NVR? The Viewtron Hybrid DVR supports all the coax cameras as well as IP cameras. Why wouldn't you just go with one of those? There's several reasons. So number one, our Viewtron NVRs are fully integrated with our Viewtron AI cameras. Our AI cameras are all IP cameras, and AI cameras support object detection. These cameras can detect human objects, vehicle objects, cars, trucks, and other non-motorized vehicles like bicycles. They can do facial recognition, and some of them can do automatic license plate recognition. Those are our AI IP cameras, and all of those functions are fully integrated into the Viewtron NVRs, meaning from the NVR interface, you could do things like create intrusion zones so that when a human or a car enters that area, it triggers recording, it can send you a push notification, it can trigger external alarms. That's fully integrated with the NVR. However, it's not fully integrated with our DVR, so you don't get to take advantage of the AI software. And that AI object detection, it solves a huge problem with that legacy that you see in legacy CCTV camera systems. And that's false positives from motion detection. If you've ever had one of these systems and you have motion detection set up, especially in an outdoor camera, you'll know that it'll drive you crazy with false alarms because it doesn't know the difference between a person intruding in an area and a tree blowing in the wind in the background. So that solves the problem. It's 99%+ accurate in detecting those types of objects, and it solves the false alarm problem. Another reason why you would go with the NVR over the DVR if you plan on using IP cameras is Because IP cameras, the video processing happens on the camera, you can put a lot more cameras on an NVR and you can record at the max resolution and max frame rate. Whereas the DVR is limited because it's doing all kinds of processing for the coax cameras, so it can't handle quite as many IP cameras. It's basically limited by the bandwidth, the traffic coming into the DVR from the cameras. For example, our 16-channel hybrid DVR can support 16 BMC cameras, and in addition, you can add 8 IP cameras. However, it only supports 30 megabits per second total of traffic coming from IP cameras into the recorder, whereas our 16-channel NVR supports 160 megabits per second. What does that mean in practice? Basically, the higher resolution the camera, the higher frame rate, and the higher quality you're recording at, the more bandwidth that's required. So for a 4K camera at 30 frames requires a lot more bandwidth than like a 720p camera at 15 frames. So although you can add IP cameras to our DVRs, you can't load them up with a whole bunch of 4K cameras at max frame rate and max resolution, whereas on the NVRs, you can. The PoE ports on the NVR make for a very simple plug-and-play installation. You simply run a Cat5 or a Cat6 network cable from the IP camera back to the NVR, plug it in, and it powers up. It's plug-and-play. Very simple to set up. So in summary, if you're installing a new system, I highly recommend you go with the Viewtron IP camera system. If you're upgrading an old system and you have coax cable in place, you'll have to weigh the benefits. So if you invested a whole bunch of money in cable infrastructure in that coax cable and you just can't invest in replacing it with network cable, the Viewtron Hybrid DVR is an excellent choice because you can use your existing legacy cameras. You can upgrade cameras, you know, over time, one by one, because you can mix and match old analog cameras with the latest 4K over coax cameras. And then if you did want to add a couple of IP cameras for the new cameras, you could do that. You have to use an external PoE switch. There's no PoE ports built into the hybrid DVRs like there is the NVR. If you want to take advantage of the AI software, you know, if human object detection or vehicle object detection is important to you, and you had a whole bunch of false positives on your legacy system and you want to address that issue, then you may want to upgrade your cable to network cable and go with the NVR and upgrade all of your cameras and upgrade the cable. If you want to add license plate recognition or facial recognition, again, you're going to need to replace your cable and go with the IP cameras with the NVR and get rid of your old coax cable and don't bother with a DVR. What else? Guys, if you have any questions about any of this, if you have questions about whether you should upgrade your old DVR, if you should leave your coax cable in place, if you're having trouble deciding if you should upgrade to network cable and get the NVR with the Viewtron IP cameras, if you want to bounce anything off me, you can email me anytime. I can be reached at mike@viewtron.com. We could also set up a free phone consultation. Just email me your questions. And if you want to have a phone call, just let me know. If you want to learn more about our Viewtron IP camera systems or the hybrid DVRs, you could see all of our Viewtron products at www.viewtron.com. Thank you for watching.